So the median overall survival in the active treatment group is 31.4 months compared to only 12.5 months in the control group. So very clear separation of the overall survival curves. But the interesting thing is, if you look at the patients who are still alive, in the active treatment group, we have 3 out of 7 who were still alive after prolonged follow-up.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Paul Peter Tack. He is the CEO of Candel Therapeutics. And Dr. Tack, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Thank you very much. Great to be here. We are very well. We are very excited for our patients about the data that we've presented today.
Yeah, the data you had out for your phase 2 trial really leaps off the page when you hear extend survival in pancreatic cancer, because as we know, people who get pancreatic cancer is basically a death sentence. But here's a bit of light shining on this. So let's take a step back and talk to everyone a little bit about what's going on here, what this trial was trying to do.
Yeah, this randomized controlled clinical trial was focused on patients with borderline resectable pancreatic cancer. So these patients typically have a tumor that invades a blood vessel, and therefore they cannot undergo surgery yet. So these patients will get chemotherapy followed by chemoradiation as standard of care. The goal is to shrink the tumor so that the patients may become operable, which is the case in about half of the patients. So that's the definition of borderline resectable pancreatic cancer. All our patients received standard of care, the same standard of care, but then the active treatment group received 2 to 3 administrations of our investigational medicine, which is CAN-2409.
Yeah. So, Dr. Tack, so the numbers that you put out here in the group, that the median overall survival rate of 31.4 months, just before we went on, I want to tell people what you said. You said, it even surprised me, and I've been in this field a long time. Tell me a bit about the results that you saw. This seems quite interesting.
Yeah, it's very interesting. So the median overall survival in the active treatment group is 31.4 months compared to only 12.5 months in the control group. So very clear separation of the overall survival curves. But the interesting thing is, if you look at the patients who are still alive, in the active treatment group, we have 3 out of 7 who were still alive after prolonged follow-up, actually 2 patients more than 5 years now. So this is very, very long. And 2 of these 3 patients had actually residual disease after surgery. So 1 had stage 4 metastatic disease, so the tumor was even not removed. The surgeon decided to close the abdomen again, right? Because there were metastases in the liver. This patient is still alive after very prolonged follow-up. The other patient had a residual tumor. So you take the tumor out, you look under the microscope at the resection, at the margin of the resection, and in this patient, there was still tumor left behind. Also, this patient is still alive after more than 5 years. So we know that that does not happen in the normal clinical course of the disease. This has a very poor prognosis. These patients live less than 6 to 12 months in normal routine care.
Yeah. So Dr. Tack, how should we be, just in the layman's terms, how should the general public be looking at this and where this goes now?
Yeah, we believe this is a potential breakthrough in the treatment of borderline resectable pancreatic cancer. So we want to develop it in exactly the same population. So the next step is, now that we see this very clear separation based on the small clinical trial, where you don't have placebo effects or whatever, so we believe this is real. Now we want to confirm this in a large randomized controlled clinical trial, which is going to be quite similar to the design of the current trial. And hopefully that will ultimately lead to approval. We got from the FDA in the past fast track designation and orphan drug designation, which will help us to accelerate development. So we want to develop it in this population. If everything goes well and if approved in the future, then we will probably also test it in other stages of pancreatic cancer.
Yeah. Dr. Tack, lastly, I mentioned you're in this field, you've been in this field for a long time. Can you talk to me about when you see results, something like this, and that word we throw around a lot called hope, in what is literally a family-shattering disease of pancreatic cancer? As a doctor, what does that make you feel like?
Well, this reminds us every day why we are in this business, working day and night to really be on the frontier of cutting-edge science in the field of oncology, to help patients with the largest unmet need, like pancreatic cancer, like brain cancer, like early prostate cancer, like non-small cell lung cancer, patients who have failed everything basically. If we can really change their life with a good quality of life and they live longer, as we've shown here with the overall survival data, that is an enormous motivation. That's why we are doing this. At the same time, we believe this is how we will create value for all of our shareholders and other people who are involved in this, including our employees.
Absolutely. Dr. Tack, thank you so much. Very exciting news, and look forward to continuing to follow this as it develops. So appreciate your time.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
All right, there is Dr. Paul Peter Tack. He's the CEO of Candel Therapeutics.